Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we will talk about production of citric acid. Citric acid is a weak organic dicarboxylic acid found in citrus fruits. The example of citrus fruits are lemon, orange, tomatoes, beets, etc. These are those fruits which contain sufficient amount of citric acid and they are classified as acid fruits. Citric acid is produced by three different methods: fermentation, chemical synthesis, and extraction from the citrus fruits. There are different strains which are used for the production of citric acid. Many strains excrete traces of citric acid as a metabolite of primary metabolism. Various strains of fungi, yeast, bacteria were reported, such as Penicillium luteum, Penicillium purpurginum, Penicillium restrictum, and there are other examples as well. Only mutants of Aspergillus and yeast genus Candida have almost exclusively been utilized. Now, we'll talk about the production process. Basically, surface and submerged fermentation techniques are used, and in the past, there were traditional methods for the preparation of citric acid, and that method was just to extract the fruit juices from the citric fruits, but that methods were not that much appropriate due to getting the less amount of product. So the methods like surface or submerged fermentation dominated the traditional methods. Promising results were obtained in fed batch process and by continuous fermentation. Citric acid fermentation using immobilized A-Niger cells on various kinds of carriers such as glass, polyurethane foams, and entrapment in calcium alginate beads, polyacrylates, gels, agarose, cellulose carrier, metal screens, and polyester felts. Now, there are different methods. So, we will start with the surface fermentation process. Molasses substrate, 15-20% of sucrose added nutrients, and then acidified with phosphoric acid to maintain the pH of 6 to 6.5, and then heated at temperature around 110 degrees Celsius for 15 to 45 minutes. After that, potassium hexacyanoferrate is added to the hot substrate to precipitate or complex trace metals, metals like iron, magnesium, zinc, etc., and to act in excess as a metabolic inhibitor, restricting growth and promoting acid production. Inoculation is performed in two ways: as a suspension of conidia added to the cooled medium, or as a dry conidia mixed with the sterile air and spread as an aerosol over the trays. Then the temperature is kept constant at 30 degrees Celsius during the fermentation by means of air current. Within 24 hours after inoculation, the germinating spores start forming a 2 to 3 cm cover blanket of the mycelium floating on the surface of that particular substrate. As a result of the uptake of ammonium ions, the pH of the substrate falls to 2, and initially the pH was maintained around 6 to 6.5. Then the fully developed mycelium floats as a thick white layer on the nutrient solution. The fermentation process stops after 8 to 14 days, and then the recovery of mycelium to extract citric acid. Now, the next method is solid state fermentation. In this method, the solid substrate is soaked with water up to 65 to 70% of water content. After the removal of excess water, the mass undergoes a steaming process. After that, sterile starch paste is inoculated by spreading Aspergillus niger conidia in the form of aerosol or as a liquid conidia suspension on the substrate surface. The pH of the substrate is about 5 to 5.5 and incubation temperature is around 28 to 30 degrees Celsius. Growth can be accelerated by adding alpha amylase, although the fungus can hydrolyze starch with its own alpha amylase. During the citric acid production, pH drops to values below 2. Then the solid state surface process takes around 5 to 8 days, at the end of which the entire process is extracted with hot water. On other cases, mechanical passes are also used to obtain more citric acid from the cells. Now, the next method is submerged fermentation. In this method, beet molasses substrate around 12 to 15% reducing sugar content, nutritive salts such as ammonium nitrate or potassium dihydrogenate phosphate are added. pH of the substrate is maintained to 5.5 to 5.9. The process can usually run in one or two stages using hydrophilic spores, suspensions of germinating conidia from the propagator stage. Amounts of spores are 5 to 25 into 106 per liter of substrate. The development of the hyphae and the aggregation generally requires around 9 to 25 hours at a temperature of 32 degrees Celsius. After that, mycelia aggregation and spherical pellets were collected. The productive form can be detected after 24 hours of inoculation. The change of pH in this phase is from 5.5 to 3.5 for beet molasses substrate and 2.2 for the sucrose substrate. And in this method, the fermentation takes around 6 to 8 days and later citric acid is purified with mycelium. There are different factors which are affecting the production of citric acid. What are those factors? pH, concentration of carbon source, nitrogen and phosphate limitation, aeration, traces elements, and lower alcohol. Now, after the production of citric acid, we have to recover. For the recovery of the citric acid, two processes are used, surface processed or submerged process. So now the first step is separation of biomass from fermentation broth. After that, separated mycelia retain about 50% of the citric acid formed during fermentation. In case of surface process, fermentation fluid drain. After that, hot water introduction to wash out the remaining citric acid from the mycelial mats. After that, filtration cakes were formed, not more than 0.2% of citric acid. And these are dried to yield a protein-rich feed. And all these processes, that is surface process and submerged process, can be used for the recovery of citric acid. Now, submerged process. Firstly, heated up to 70 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes for protein coagulation. After that, oxalic acid removal by addition of calcium hydroxide. Now we will discuss about the applications of citric acid. Citric acid is accepted as grass, generally recognized as safe to use, and it is approved by the joint FAO WHO expert committee on food additives. Citric acid monohydrate is widely used as preservative, flavor enhancer, emulsifying agents, pH adjustment, and carbonation. Hope you understood about today's presentation, that is production of citric acid. In our next presentations, I will describe about production of penicillin, production of vitamin B12. So, thank you.